Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a makeup tutorial for you, which is inspired by a look by Alice Faas. Basically this isn't really going to be a look that's very wearable. Obviously, even I would have second thoughts about actually going grocery shopping with this. But still, I do think it's very fun to do, and it's just something more avant-garde and like extreme and like just fun to do, smoky, dramatic, yep. Let's get on to it. Now, first off, I'm just gonna prime my eyelids. What else is new? The idea basically is I want to do a look inspired by this picture by Alice Faas. Phone, don't. Anyway, yeah. I don't want to do an exact recreation because, I don't know, I just don't really like filming exact recreations of things. I want to give my own spin to it, but I am going to do it in purple because I love purple. I just love purple. Basically it's going to be inspired, not exactly the same. What I'm trying to say is I have no idea how this is going to turn out, but we're just going to start somewhere and see where we end. Now, first off, I'm going to go for purple and I'm going to do it a bit more angular because I like angular, more like cat eye-ish looks on myself. I want to do a sort of wearable-ish version, but not completely wearable. I still want it to be extreme and more like avant-garde rather than casual. But, you know, just something that you might be able to wear to a festival. You know, all the things that actually aren't happening this year. Just wearable, but not... Wearable was very specifically wearable in terms of occasions. Sort of. It makes sense in my head. I'm just stuffing this on basically with quite a dense blending brush. Just so it's nice and opaque. Now next up, I'm just really wiping off my brush really well and then going into a lavender shade because I want to blend it out a little. Seriously, I gotta admit, until I read in the newspaper that Alice Faas had died, I had no idea that she actually was Dutch. I had no idea that she was actually from the same country as me, like seriously. I live under a rock apparently. Well, it's not that, I think that like, it's like... Great grammar. Point being, I feel like just, I don't know, makeup artists just don't seem to really like... Even the really big ones like Alice Faas just don't really seem to pop up much in the news, I guess. Like, it's usually about, like, you know... Yeah, people you really like... Of course, makeup artists work more behind the scenes. So you hear more about people who are actually, you know, in front of the camera. So, yeah, I had absolutely no idea. But, like, I did always really... Like her looks in the sense of they're not wearable, but they're really, really creative and really out there and really cool. I really just wanted to do a recreation of a look, or at least a look inspired by a look of hers. And this was really the one that stood out to me as something that, you know, I just really wanted to try to adapt to my face. Also, partly because it's a very smoky look, like a lot of the looks she did... there were also things with like line work and all, and I feel like that just looks like, this is my personal opinion, I feel like it looks better on like someone with an actual like symmetrical face. That's not me. Like, I just didn't feel like I could make that look good on myself. So that's why I went for a more smoky one, because I feel like I can actually make this work on me, hopefully. So yeah. Now I'm just applying a brow bone highlight that's basically a white gold shimmery shade. By the way, unfortunately, I don't actually have any makeup by Alice Faas, just because it's a bit above my budget. Eternally broke here. Like, I do want to try it because it seems fascinating, the whole thing of it being like in those metal pans and all. I don't know, I might try it one day once I'm not... very pathetically broke anymore. Now moving on to a black shade with purple shimmers in it. Also, I gotta admit, being broke, most of the reason I'm broke right now is because I bought really, really beautiful shoes. And they were really expensive and I didn't really need them, but they were so gorgeous and I've been wanting them for a while. So I finally gave myself permission to buy them. And now I'm broke. Yeah. Also, I don't know, like, whenever I actually do end up buying makeup, I, not always, but most of the time, I end up just buying, well, just repurchasing really makeup that I have already been using for some time and has just run out. Like, I actually don't really often buy something completely new unless it's a budget brand, because I'm a bit of a cheapskate, I suppose. And also what the thing is, right now, of course, you can't actually use samples in stores, so you gotta buy it blind, so to speak. Which, I don't know, is also something that just makes me nervous, because I always want to try swatches before I buy something, so... Yeah, I guess I'll buy more makeup again, more new makeup, you know, once I'm actually... Once we're actually... Once I'm actually able to, you know, swatch stuff again in store, so when we're, as an entire planet, out of this, you know, current situation. But yeah, for now I'm just gonna stick to what I know. Now for the bottom eyelid, I'm just going to go in with the dark shade as well first. And then blend it out with that like darker purple shade. Just keeping it nice and smoky. I feel like this eye is less purple for some reason. I didn't apply any primer below my eye, which probably also doesn't help. Anyway, then I'm just wiping down my brush again and going into a shimmery purple shade, a very pale one, for the highlight in the inner corner. Just a little bit. Then the waterline with a burgundy pencil, and then I think we're, for the moment, done with the eyes. Okay, I gotta admit that I suddenly had a revelation. Not a good one. I realized that I completely forgot to do skincare. Like, completely forgot to do skincare. I mean, at least the primer is a little bit creamy, and now I'm using a BB cream just to give my skin some form of nourishment. Because I'm being a brute to my skin today, apparently. Yeah, I make it sound like a good thing that I'm using a BB cream, but actually this BB cream... It looks better than I thought it would, but it's... Well, I have no idea how old it is, so I have no idea, I have no idea what this is going to do to my skin and how my skin is going to look tomorrow, so that's going to be a surprise. But yeah, I hope it won't give me breakouts from hell. And that's really, like, hoping is all I can do. Now, I'm just going to apply a whole lot of concealer in the, probably vain hopes of saving this a little bit. In the original picture it's more like the model is just, you know, overall pale. You know, like I would be too if I would have actually matched my face with my neck. Also, by the way, if you do want a complete full coverage face, I do recommend actually doing your face before the eyeshadow and just being a lot more careful with the eyeshadow than I was, because I get away with it because this is a BB cream. Well, what I'm blending out now is concealer, but like a BB cream you can sort of like blend towards the makeup and it won't really show that it doesn't actually go beneath the makeup. But obviously with a full coverage foundation you're gonna see an edge otherwise, so might want to do that beforehand if you choose to do that. Now for blush I just decided to go for my one and only cream blush, of which I don't know the age, but then again I'm also wearing a BB cream that I don't know the age of either. Goes more from like the back of the face to the front, it seems, in the picture, as far as I can tell, at least. but yeah, anyway, I really hope this isn't gonna give me breakouts either, but then again, on top of the BB cream, we can't really make it much worse at this point, can we? I'm working as a makeup artist tomorrow, so I'm really hoping that I'll only have to wear a little face mask while applying makeup to the model and not a full-on... paper bag over my head to hide my awful, awful skin. I really hope that's not gonna be necessary. Anyway, we're just going for it. Okay, I gotta admit that I actually quite like the effect of a cream blush. This was a really ancient one by Makeup Academy, of which I have no idea if they still even sell it. I don't know, like I might actually try to use cream products more often. I quite like it. Anyway, I'm just going to apply powder now and then figure out what the next step is going to be. Okay, I think because of the whole avant-garde-ish theme, I'm going to use a spoolie and concealer to do my eyebrows. I have no idea how this is going to work out. It actually covers them. I'm surprised. That actually looks quite cool. Weird. But cool. On the model there's also eyeshadow on there, so I'm going to copy that as well. I'm just mixing the purple shade and the lavender shade, the matte ones. And just bringing the color up onto my eyebrows. And because of the concealer on them, it actually sort of... I don't know, it seems to adhere to them. I am quitting where the eyebrow ends. Because I somehow want them to be defined, because it looks like that on the picture as well, and I think it's a really cool look. And I'm leaving a gap here where the highlighter is. And I'm just being really careful, because I think it's going to be really difficult to remove anything at this point if I don't like it. So I don't want to risk that. Okay, and then on the rest of the eyebrow, I'm going to apply the other shades. The other shade, the highlight shade is what I'm talking about. Yeah, I think it looks quite cool. Now, I just wanted to be a little bit more blended on the bottom, so I'm just using a big fluffer blender. And just going over that edge there. Doesn't need to be perfectly smooth, I just want it to be a little bit smoother. Now lastly, the lips. I want to go for gloss because I want to try to get this sort of lip result as well. I'm just going to dig through my lipstick drawer until I find something similar. Okay, so I've got a lip pencil in a purplish shade and a lip gloss, a plumping one that's so old that it's actually quite... It smells horrible and tastes horrible, and I wouldn't recommend anyone to use a lip gloss this old, but I'm gonna use it, so do it as stay, not as I do. Yeah. And it leaves us with the final results. I gotta say, I actually quite like how this turned out. It turned out more wearable than I thought it would, really. Also, I don't know, like, as usually I'm the sort of person I always want, especially with a more dark eye look, I always want the eyebrows to be, you know, very dark and, like, drawn in as well. But just completely almost disregarding the eyebrows and making them part of the eye look rather than a thing on their own, I don't know, I like it. Like, and I also, like, of course, I didn't do contour. Contouring. This lip gloss tastes absolutely terrible and I just swallowed a bit of it. It's so pretty though. Anyway, point being, I didn't contour my nose or anything. And like I said, just disregarding the eyebrows and just making the lips look huge. I look different than usual, but I kind of like it. Also, by the way, for the lips, I believe she used to use a mixture of like glycerin and Vaseline or something. I read it somewhere. But I didn't know how well my lip pencil would hold up with that, so that's why I went for an ancient gloss. If you want to know exactly what products I use, by the way, they will be below the video in the description as always. And of course, you don't need to use the same products I did, really, you know, as long as you have pigmented purple eyeshadows, you'll be fine. And I wouldn't recommend using a lip gloss that's like 5 years expired anyway in the first place. But yeah, anyway, if you want to see more of my tutorials, you can also subscribe to my channel. I upload 3 times a week, and 2 of those times it'll be a makeup tutorial. If you enjoyed this particular video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And that was it for today. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!